today I have the Schmidt Ruben, or as others might call it, the Vogelsang Ruben, since Vogelsang and Rebholz had changed the lugs on the bolt here from the rear of the Schmidt Ruben, from the rear up to the front of the bolt sleeve. And Schmidt said it couldn't be done or it wasn't feasible to do it. So Vogelsang and his assistant, Rebholz, worked on it and came up with this system. It was able to withstand the greater pressures of the newer ammo that was coming out. And when this rifle was made in this configuration, they found that the 96s, since it had the same bolt and locking system, it could withstand the same pressure, so they modified those to this configuration from the, because the 96s were still based generally on the 89s, except it had the updated bolt in it, therefore was able to handle the higher pressures of the GP90. This is using the GP11, and they found it could still work. So on this one, this is, I believe, if I remember correctly, serial dated, and it's like 1919. And we'll get in a closer look to that. It has the pressure test markings on it. It has, this one has a rectangle with the cross on it with the M for Inspector Mullman. This has the B, which people have said it designates a new barrel. This one has an H here. I was looking, I couldn't really find out what that H meant unless it's also an inspector mark. This has the CN, which might mean a chrome nickel. If I remember correctly, that's for a chrome nickel receiver made that way. This has a different number than this, and I don't know if there's a serial number on the little plunger for the sight. This has matching numbers here, though the magazine is a different number. This does have like a B that's stamped in there. This has the little emblem, the cross markings for the small parts. Though they said basically the small markings up here means the firing test, whereas the backwards B with the P is the pressure test. So this is the M1911. Move my coffee out of the way. And this one is the updated 96 to this configuration. They added the pistol grip here. This has a different butt plate because that's still similar to the 89. You know, they changed the mag on this to the 6-round versus whereas before on the 89s they were the 12 rounds. They initially changed the sights to the tangent from the quadrant. And then we have the K11, which is the miniature version of the 1911 for the infantry. So I'll move these out of the way. We'll go over, I'll talk about this one, and then I'll put this one back up and show you some close-ups of that. Then we'll disassemble this, show you what's underneath the stock and for the barrel. So with the widespread adoption of the Spitzer round, it caused problems on the bolt of the 1889 because of the increased velocity and pressure of that. So the Vogelsang and Ribolt strengthened the bolt by moving the locking lugs forward, whereas before they were on the back of the bolt sleeve, now they're on the forward part of the bolt sleeve. And the trials for the M1911, they were conducted from 1908 to 1910, and it was approved in January of 1913. At that time, there was a decree to convert the 1896 rifles, which looked like the 1899 rifles, to the new 1911 pattern, which I showed you there earlier. The M1911 has the overall length of 51.5, and that's a 0.3 difference being longer than the 9611s. It weighs right at 10 pounds. It has the tangent leaf sight, a four groove barrel, and a six round magazine. And as I said, my serial date puts this around 1919, somewhere in that time frame. The backwards B with the P is a pressure test proof. The small cross, they say, is a shooting test mark. The rear of my rear sight base has the plus or the cross with the CN, which is the receiver is made of the chrome nickel. Underneath my serial number there, it has a 29, which means it went through a repair or refurbishment in 1929. It also has the P for the privatization. So we'll take a closer look at this and then I'll disassemble it. And this does have the flat butt plate versus the more rounded one on the 9611. This was made with the pistol grip versus the 9611 being grafted onto it. My cocking knob here looks good condition, has a crack right there, not bad. Moving up, you see the little cross there, backwards B with the P for the pressure test and the shooting test. Again, there's a B on there. Let me flip up the sight here for you. And right in there, the CN with the little cross for the chrome nickel receiver. And this one still has the hinge front barrel band with the stacking hook and the bayonet lug on it. I'll turn this over, show you the other side. First, before I turn it over, you can see right there the little shield with the cross in it, which is also an inspector's mark on the for the wood. Here's the other side of it. And they said there was a difference in the trigger guard for the M1911 versus the 9611s. And in my first video showing them, that's real hard to tell. And I don't know if there is. And maybe I just happen to have one where they're not. So I'm not sure what that difference is. There's the 29 underneath the serial number, the P, matching numbers. Matching numbers on the bolt. My mag does not match. Back up here, the cross. There's the rectangle with the M in it for Inspector Muhlmann. I'm not sure. The B. There's the backwards B with the P. There's that H. I'll disassemble this and show you underneath the wood and underneath the barrel. This is hinged. And this does have that little parts marking. This one has the parts marking on it also. This does slide down and go right off over the front sight. This has a little lip, fits underneath the front sight base, has a little marking there. This here has the shield with the marking in it for the inspector on the wood. Has a little circle, something in it. Has matching serial numbers to the receiver and bolt and barrel. And I did open this up on the buttstock earlier. It does not have a troop tag. Again, the little markings here on the metal. Loosen these up a little bit. I don't like having pressure by loosening up one and having the other side still tight. Darn it. I'm gonna have to find that screw now. This went right between the slats. And this does have the serial number, matches this, which matches the rifle. It also has the shield with the cross in it for the inspector mark. There's a number on the trigger this side. This side has the little cross. Looks like there's the backwards R with a P and a circle there. I'm not sure what that is. This looks like there's a serial number here. This looks like a B86. I'm not sure. It has the marking H and H, which is Hammerly and Hush, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Again, here's the barrel for floating the barrel. So I'll give you guys a closer look at this. And I have my bag underneath here. This screw fell right on my bag. I didn't have to try to look in the grass for it. So here's the top hand guard, matching numbers. There's the shield with the cross in it for inspector's mark. There's a circle there, but I can't tell what is inside of that circle. It does look like I need to clean this up a little bit. That just rubs right off. So here's, let me turn this around. There's an inspector's mark again. Going up here, matching serial numbers. Make sure my screws don't roll away this time. On the mag, has a 10. And this here there's a T, which I believe is another inspector's mark. Not sure what that marking is, right? That stamping is there. So let's go over here to the barrel. So here's under the barrel. See right there, Looks like a B86 with an H and H. Possibly a serial number there. And kind of a I oval type stamping there. Looks like number 11 there. Back here on the trigger, there's like that backwards R with the P, stamping of the cross. This side looks like a 311, which possibly is a 11 right there. Back here on the bolt, a little cross stamping, serial numbers, a little cross stamping. There's like a can't tell. It's maybe an ED, you know, in a script. Looks like over here, that's, I can't tell, maybe a WC with a little stamping after it. I'm gonna have to look that up. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put this back together. There's the barrel band with that stamping. And this has the front band. There's the stamping on that one. So I'm going to go ahead and get this put back together for you, and we'll go shooting. Again, I'm just going to tighten these down a little bit at a time, back and forth, rather than causing uneven pressure at one end on the other ones. Always make sure you get that up here. There's that little lip on this, and make sure you got to get it so it's not underneath or out past it. Easier. There we go. And that has a little ridge which fits in the ridge in there. All right, so there we go. Now to go out and do some shooting with it. I'm gonna be shooting the M1911, the infantry Gewehr. Gonna be using the PPU, full metal jacket, bowtail, 174 grain. 5 shots down on target. We'll go take a look at that. One thing earlier I forgot to mention is on my sling, there's a marking here. After I shoot the 5 shots, before we go check the target, I'll show you that on the sling. That's the 5 rounds. We'll go check the target. I'll show you the marking on this sling. And there's that marking or stamping here on the sling. Can't really make out what it is. Looks like it has a 96 date. And what's stamped here, I don't know, up here it kind of looks like it starts with a J or something. Looks like there's a K in there. Over here on the right looks like a B-E-R. I just don't know. I'm going to have to look this up to see what this might be. If you guys know, you could let me know. I appreciate it. There's my 5 rounds on the target. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. A little bit of a spread, you know, again, I'm a little bit to the left on this.